Now, many of you who've taken the Johnson & Johnson vaccine may be wondering what symptoms you need to be looking out for and how long after getting the vaccine should you be worried. Well, we have you covered as we continue our team coverage with the latest developments. Let's bring in Liza Lucas. She's walking us through what you should keep an eye out for when it comes to those symptoms. Liza.
Sheba, we want to start by saying experts are really summing this up as a, quote, extremely rare reaction. That being said, it has been seen in the reported 6 cases so far in a select group, women under 50 and under select time frame within that 16 to 13 day window. So experts saying if it's been more than a month since you got your dose of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, the risk is very low. Now, the CDC does say if you experience a severe headache, abdominal pain, leg pain, or shortness of breath, and you got the Johnson & Johnson vaccine within the last 3 weeks or so, you should contact your doctor. And you want to make sure your doctor knows that you have been recently vaccinated. That is important information that you'll want to be sharing with them. Now, as we walk through these symptoms, we want to point out these are very different from the mild flu-like symptoms that are commonly reported after people get one of the 3 vaccines. So that's something to note. And as we turn to Georgia, we actually checked in with DPH and they tell us that the state received more than 300,000 Johnson & Johnson vaccine doses. About a third of those have been given out so far. And DPH officials telling us that as of yesterday, there have been no reported cases of these rare blood clots here in Georgia.